So it's time to start enjoying life again. And there's something that's going to be online, another one of these virtual gigs. But it's not going to be like the Take That one that you'll see online tonight, where they're all doing it from their own kitchens. This is an actual thing. It's in a proper theatre, stage, lighting, the sound, the video quality, everything will be spot on. You can enjoy it. And it's with a John Lennon UK tribute act. It's basically this guy won the TV show The Big Audition and has landed the role of John Lennon in one of the Beatles tributes. Gaz Keenan joins us. Hey, Gaz.
Hello, mate. How's it going? All right?
I'm good as gold, thank you. Yeah. I mean, first of all, why John Lennon? Out of all the Beatles, why do you love John Lennon so much?
Well, I've always loved John, to be fair, but it was a couple of years ago where I saw an audition link for, like, the Bootleg Beatles. And, you know, I've been a musician since I was, you know, a teenager. But my wife said, well, why don't you go for it? You know, you're a scouser and you've got a big nose, so give it a go.
And what about the actual impersonation, doing the John Lennon voice? What sort of characteristics are in his style of singing? Is there any, because he must, you know, we'll hear one of your songs in a minute. You really do replicate it quite well.
Yeah, I mean, it's just something you've got to work at. I mean, I haven't really been a singer for that long. I mean, it's only a few years that I've been singing. I'm a musician, you know, first and foremost. I play the guitar and, you know, the other instruments. But yeah, I started singing in a grunge band, and then my wife said that, and I just started listening to his songs and getting the take on his voice. And he's got quite a soulful voice, you know, but he's just got little mannerisms that it's the sort of a breathlessness to a lot of it, and then quite acerbic, and it's more the attitude, to be quite honest.
Yeah, no, I totally get that. I absolutely get what you mean. Now, this gig that we can see on the internet, how did this come all about? How did you get involved in this?
Well, so obviously we haven't done a gig since lockdown started, which, you know, is again 3 months ago or whatever it is. And my keyboard player, Mark Dryden, he's been very active in figuring out a way to get music back. So he's been talking to, like, the Welsh government, the English government, because he's based in Wales, trying to figure out how theatres and all the rest of it are going to survive after this, and also how to start getting things back in. So it's really his baby, and he's done all the groundwork. He's got a production company in. So we're putting on this show, and it's going to be without an audience, but it is going to be a full live band, and it's going to be a high-quality stream. And yeah, we're going to work, essentially. That's what we're doing. We're going
to work
at the venue for the day, you know.
And it must be, difficult, because the Eurovision didn't do it. Everyone was talking from their homes on webcams, and Take That tonight doing this online stream. They're all going to be broadcasting from their homes. How is it going to work with social distancing on stage? How are you going to get around this?
Yeah, so we've drawn up a number of different stage plans that you know, follows the guidelines of the 2 meter distance between us. So we've got different stage plans. We're going to get in there on the day, set the cameras up, and see which one works best. But we're following the guidelines that have been, I think, put forward by the likes of BBC, ITV, I think Sky, you know, for broadcasting. So that's the way we're going. So we're going to make sure that all social distancing is followed. You know, we're going to be very careful, and safety first for everybody. You know, so.
Well, it's going to be really special to see it live. When we're watching the stream and there's someone on stage, it's like, wow, that's live, because we just haven't seen anything like that for so long. And it's so important as well to keep these venues going through lockdown, isn't it?
That's what it's all about. I mean, that is our main concern here. We've been speaking to a lot of different venues, and they've all got different takes on it. They've all got different ideas of how they're going to survive and what it's going to look like. And we just, I think it's a UK first for actually getting into a venue and streaming a live band. I believe so. And we've just got to suck it and see, you know, get in there. To see what interest we get, because it's not going to be the same. It's not going to be the same as going to a gig and experiencing a live band. But we've got to try and get these venues working again and get something going, you know, because, hopefully, like you say, this phase is almost over in Guernsey. Obviously, it seems like you're a bit more advanced than us. But what if it all happens again? You know?
Yeah. Yeah, no, so, this is it. You just don't know. We're certainly not complacent. We're very, very lucky that we've managed to get through this. No one can believe it, not least the states, the government over here. They said in the press conference last week, we can't believe how far forward we are. And Jersey isn't as lucky. And obviously, where you are at the minute in England, that's a different kettle of fish entirely. But yeah, we can just carry on and do what we can do and try and enjoy ourselves. What sort of songs are going to be in the set list then?
So it's going to be John Lennon solo only. We couldn't get the rights. It's a UK only stream, so we've been working with the Performing Rights Society to make sure that we're doing everything above board and all the, you know, the dots and the ticks are sorted. So we haven't got the permission to use the Beatles. We've got permission to use John Lennon solo songs. So it's going to be a nice little set of his greatest bangers. So, yeah, it's going to be nice.
Love it. Look, you can.
Obviously, we're going to be doing Isolation. Goes without saying.
Yeah, no, that'll go down well. We'll all be rolling our eyes. It's happening on the 6th of June at 7 p.m. You can see it. It's streamed for free at johnlennontribute.com/stream. And this really does sound like a really professional show they've been working on. So do check it out. And also, they're spending a lot of their own money as well to satisfy PRS and PPL. And also the streaming service and also the fantastic crew with the lighting and everything that's going to make it look like a pro gig. So that's great. johnlennontribute.com/stream. And that's the 6th of June, 7 p.m. Look, Gaz, I'm going to get you to... We're going to play one of your songs and we can hear your voice singing, doing your John Lennon. Now, could you introduce your song for us?
Yeah, so this is a personal favourite of mine of his solo career. A wonderful, wonderful song, absolutely beautiful. And it shows off the gentler, sort of more melancholy side of Lennon, in my opinion. And it's Jealous Guy, belter.
just a jealous guy. Watch out now, just a jealous guy. Look out, baby, just a jealous guy.
Isn't that great? John Lennon impersonator and big audition winner, Gaz Keenan, who joined us for a little chat.